Okay, you want to start by raising the vehicle and safely placing jack stands underneath it. If it has a skid plate, at this point you can proceed to removing that. Now for the pitman arm. There's a nut there on the bottom. They tend to be really tight most times. You're going to want to get yourself an impact gun. You might have to use some heat. And the proper pitman arm puller is essential in doing a job like this. Remember, these things could be a real bear coming off, but they'll come. Alright, next you're going to want to remove that cover. Just like so. And there's a shot of the steering knuckle. There's one single bolt that goes through that steering knuckle. It's called a pinch style setup. So you want to proceed to removing that pinch bolt. And then take yourself a chisel or something. And there's a shot of that bolt. Put it in between that gap. Now loosen it up and then slide it up. Whatever you do, do not turn the steering wheel once that steering column is loose. Doing so will damage the clock spring and get it out of the line. Okay, let's pause here for a minute and go over this clock spring, because it is a very important step and something that can be really critical and cause you more work if you do accidentally move the steering wheel or the steering knuckle, steering column, while the knuckle is removed from the steering gear. When I say clock spring, what that is, that's your contacts. That's your that's what applies the power and all the functions to the steering wheel for your controls on your steering wheel. Back in the day, they used a style that used contacts, like a spring-loaded contact that just rode the surface of the opposing side. Nowadays, it's just not possible because there's so many wires. So they use a ribbon-style cable. It's hard to see it in this illustration. But underneath that cover, underneath the steering wheel, there's a ribbon-style cable that they use. And how this works is that they take a ribbon-style cable and they wrap it tight and then they loosen it to center in a relaxed position. And they install that with the steering wheel straight ahead and the clock spring in a relaxed position. And they give you just enough room, just enough cable to make your complete turn to your stop to your right and the stop to the left. Now the problem with this, since they just give you enough room, because there's only enough room inside this housing to allow for so much ribbon cable, that if you were to get this clock spring off one turn to the right, let's say, and you reinstall your steering knuckle, when you get everything buttoned up and you turn your steering wheel all the way to the stop to the right, it'll never make the cable, won't have enough play. Won't have enough travel to make that revolution to the right, and you will eventually run out of cable, and it's so brittle it'll snap. So it's very important not to move the steering wheel while that knuckle's detached. Now, I have done it in the past, and if it does happen to you, there are ways of getting it close. What I do and what I have done is taken out with steering knuckle removed, if the steering wheel is accidentally moved, go inside and with your fingertips very lightly and slowly turn the wheel all the way, let's say, to the right. Turn it to the right until you start to feel the ribbon cable get tight and stop. Then count the turns all the way back to the left until you start feeling resistance. I usually find it's right around 5 turns. Then you split the difference. Go 2.5 turns back to the right, and that should be your center. And then reinstall your knuckle. And that should give you enough travel to go from the left to the right without binding the clock spring. Okay, I hope that makes sense. If you have any questions, just visit me at the forum and I'll answer them for you. I proceed to removing the hoses.
I don't know if you can see this line here, but the line's frozen up here on the pump, so I'm going to just take off the return line. Right here, it's a low pressure return line. Wow, is this thing rusted out. Look at all that.
Once the lines are off, you can proceed to removing the three bolts that hold the steering box on. As you see, there's a shot of them. There's no nuts on the other side. They screw right into the steering box. I got the new low pressure. I got the new steering box there with the low pressure hose screwed on with the new O-ring. You want to definitely be sure to install new O-rings when doing this job. As you can see, the weather wasn't cooperating with me. Alright, just reverse procedures to reinstall on the new steering box. As you can see, I got that dust cover slid back down. Knuckles on. Pinch bolts in tight. Pitman's arms up. Nice and tight. You see that lock wires are squished. Got the three bolts going through the frame. They're nice and tight. The power steering hoses are on. Nice, tight, secure. Just shot at the three bolts. You know, want to make sure you get them nice and tight. Okay, now in the Persian system. This is going to be an essential step. Whenever you have a power steering system open, you need to purge the system, otherwise damage may occur. This method we're going to be using is going to be using a vacuum pump. It's a good method, and it works. You're going to want to remove your reservoir cap for your power steering pump, and find yourself an adapter for your vacuum pump that fits snugly in the cap, where the cap would go. Next, you're going to want to apply your maximum vacuum, 20 to 25 inches, and maintain for like 3 to 5 minutes with the engine idling. Release the vacuum and remove the vacuum pump. Check the fluid. Do not overfill the reservoir. Reinstall the vacuum pump. Apply and maintain maximum vacuum, 20 to 25 inches, with the engine idling. Next, we're going to want to cycle the steering wheel. Cycle the steering wheel every 30 seconds from the left to the right. Stop the engine. Release the vacuum and remove the vacuum pump. Install the reservoir cap. Check the fluid level. All connections for leaks. And if noise or any other issues occur, just repeat the steps above. Okay, so that's pretty much all there is to removing and replacing the power steering gear in a Ford F-150. If you're wondering, the reason why this one was removed and replaced with a remanufactured box was because the lower seal blew out and was attempted to be replaced. However, the lower bushing was shot. The shaft was wore. The best alternative was to replace the steering box with the remanufactured one. Okay, guys, I hope you enjoyed. If you have any questions, feel free to ask.